Of all the planets in the universe that we know of, the Earth is the only one with Wi-Fi. Also, breathable oxygen. So, count your blessings. Hey there, denizens of the internet. Jules here for DNews. Unless you're somehow watching this on a bootleg flea market DNews DVD, you're in the top 40%. Congratulations. I'm talking, of course, about people who have internet access around the world. But unlike you lucky internet pioneers, there are another 4.3 billion people on the planet who either have no way of accessing the web or can't afford to. In fact, while Europe has a connection rate of about 75%, in Africa, that number is closer to just 20. So a few technology companies have tried to bridge that gap. First up was Google, which began testing its program in 2013. Google's suggestion? LTE-equipped balloons. Now, if sending internet-capable balloons into the sky sounds like the ravings of a lunatic, well, you're not the only one, which is why Google dubbed the project Loon. Well, that and it's the last four letters of balloon, and a loon is a kind of bird. Sometimes those Googlers are a little too clever. Obviously, there are some inherent challenges to using balloons. Early tests had helium leaks, which brought the balloons back down to Earth after just a day or two. Current R&D is focused on keeping balloons up for more than 100 days, and it's going pretty well. Another problem is that balloons are not known for being easy to control. That string they're attached to doesn't really take directions. So Google's plan to control the balloons is to take advantage of the stratified winds at different altitudes by raising and lowering the loon as high as 20 kilometers. With a network of hundreds of balloons all being monitored by a command center, Google thinks they can create uninterrupted wireless coverage. Plus, the balloons are solar powered. And if you're worried about losing internet at night when you're trying to Netflix and chill, don't worry, the solar panels charge up a battery to keep the chilling happening all night. Not to be outdone, Facebook is trying to deliver all your favorite cat videos by drone. The drone, named Aquila, which is Latin for eagle because everything's got to be a bird reference, is a giant flying solar-powered wing. The Aquila will use an infrared laser that pulses on and off billions of times a second to transmit data, instead of sending it over radio frequencies, the way Wi-Fi does. It's kind of like a fiber optic cable, but without the cable. Basically, Facebook will literally beam memes. And if you're into beans, then it'll beam bean memes. But there's a problem. Wings only work when air is flowing over them. So the drones need to keep moving. And since they're solar powered, it would be inefficient to store energy for the motors to use at night. Facebook tackles both of these problems by having the drone gain altitude during the day and gently drift down at night. Using this technique, an Aquila can stay in the air for 90 days. Its altitude will vary between 18 and 27 kilometers, at least 6 kilometers higher than commercial aircraft. But there's a catch. It's not the entire internet. Facebook's Aquila will transmit a limited internet service called Free Basics, which provides forecasts, job searches, and news for free. But obviously, nothing is really free. Free Basics has been accused of violating net neutrality because it limits access to Facebook's competitors. India actually banned the Free Basics app on those grounds in February this year. Even the balloons have strings attached. Google controls almost two-thirds of the search engine market, and an influx of new users means an influx of new revenue. There's still a long way to go before the world really has global free internet, but as long as there's money to be made, these projects will likely keep happening. On the other hand, if you're sick and tired of the internet, I get it. Check out this video by Laura Ling, who visited a town that bans cell phones and Wi-Fi, just like it's the 90s.
Do some people feel as if they're living in a little bubble here?
I mean, in a sense, I feel like I'm living in a little wonderland because we have this great science going on here. And I suppose there are people that can't imagine doing without cellular service. But for most of human history, you know, we managed quite well. Think of it as living in 1980.
So what are your favorite bean memes to beam? Let us know in the comments below or send us your favorite bean memes on Twitter at DNews or to me at Jules_SU. Thanks for watching DNews. Don't forget to like and subscribe.